Hi guys, thanks for chiming back into this channel. By the way, the channel is 90 subscribers big. Woo woo! Man, dude, like I always talk about, I just do this for fun, but I went to go and check my YouTube and I was like, dude, 90? That's cool, right? So today we're gonna be doing something that I do to every one of my cars that are worth doing. I'm gonna be putting a stereo in this thing. And so I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna be doing. So I had the chance to do it in my Suburban, but I wasn't going to. I have had this Alpine amp forever. It's a 650 watt amp. I just bought a new Pioneer head unit and it was like about 55 bucks. And then a wiring harness for 10 bucks and then this is $25 at Advance Autos. And then I got my sub and it's just your standard 12 inch in a slotted box. It's a diamond sub. And yeah, dude, I'm ready to freaking slap. Man, I miss slapping so bad. And when I refer it to as slapping, I'm talking about the sub doing its thing. Having like a home theater sound in your car is always awesome. So that's what I'm gonna be doing today. And I'm gonna take you guys with me. So let's go. Well, I'm gonna be here forever because I'm trying to do this like as legit as possible. So right now I just got my amp mounted and the wiring that goes to hook up to this sub, it's under here and I just ran one wire. And so now I gotta run I got to do my head unit, then I got to pull my head unit out and I got to run a power wire from the battery to this and to the amp. Then I got to run a remote wire from the head unit to here and then RCAs to here. And yeah, it's going to be a long night, but it's going to be worth it because I'll freaking have some bass. So I know what you're thinking. You're like, man, you're really deep into this and you haven't really given much detail. So it's pretty self-explanatory. So I have my center console off, right? And so imagine this is in the car. That's our emergency brake is. There's two bolts on the side and then two bolts on the inside of this. You have to pull this little cover up right here. And there's two bolts right there. This whole section will slide out towards the back. And then you have a bolt there. And then screw there, and then this whole front end or front plastic piece will pull off to where you can get access to the stereo right here. And then, man, I don't even know what this wire does. I'm thinking it might be like the antenna wire, I'm not sure, but yeah, that's as far as I've gone. And then I'm gonna get these two screws right there and there, and then I should be able to pull this whole head unit out. So I just got my head unit out, and for you to, in order to take this out, you gotta pull off the wiring harness right here, and then there's a antenna wire right there. And then to separate the bracket off, there's just two screws on the bottom of this, where this bracket used to be like that. And it's a Phillips head, and that separates this little cubby hole too. So now I need to figure out how to get this head unit, sorry for the mess right here, to be able to connect to this factory bracket so I can have it sit in its original spot. And that's gonna be tricky. And then I gotta wire up with my factory, like a wiring harness, the stereo, and then just go from there. Now that I got the wiring all sitting here, so this is where it plugs into the back of the stereo. And then this is the end right here that goes to the factory harness on the car. And so it has another plug that was probably for like an old school like head unit back in the day, but I have all these wires right here and it's pretty self-explanatory. I even have the book right here that tells you like, you know, each color and which speaker it goes to and everything. But what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be soldering each wire. So like right here, I have purple and black to purple and black, and I'm gonna solder in the middle and then get my heat shrink, put it over the side. Put it like to the left and then put it over my wires. And then heat shrink it and then just go to the next one, next one, next one, next one. And then I'll be putting this on here and then seeing if the stereo works for one. And then two, if all four door speakers work. So yeah, let's get to soldering. So after about 30 minutes of soldering, I got all my solders heat shrinked and everything, and then I just wrapped this with some electrical tape, got this all zip tied, so it's all nice and neat. So in theory, this will go into the original harness. This will go in the back of the head unit that's over there, and this is my remote wire, which is my signal that goes to my amp, and then I have to get it grounded, and then we should at least have a head unit tonight. And then I get to go and freaking run power from the battery to the amp, and then RCAs from the head unit, then the remote wire, which is this blue wire, back to the amp, and then do a ground for the amp also. It's just, I'm only halfway there. Like, I'll have this head unit working tonight, but other than that, like, I am still trying super hard to get, like, the rest of everything working. So, yeah, just, man, lots of wiring. Just got the head unit wired up, and I got my wiring harness all connected up, and then it's connected back on the back side of the head unit, and then I got my antenna hooked up, and let's see if this radio works. Oh, yeah. Sweet! All the way to 62. I wonder if the back speakers work. Let's see. Sweet. Ah. Awesome. That was one thing that I was wondering about, if is all the speakers work. So that's awesome. Cool. So this is the trickiest part of, like, doing a sub and an amp install, is getting your your RCAs off the back of the head unit back to the sub, and then also your remote wire. So right now I'm going to be, before I put it all back together, I'm going to be routing it inside here and then out under the dash, and then running it under the carpet back all the way to the sub and amp. So it's going to take me forever and a day, but it'll be worth it in the end. I also have my power wire that goes back to the sub to power it with my fusible link hooked up to the fuse box right here. I could have gone from here on the positive side of the fuse box or to the battery. I just chose to go from here. It's a little bit closer, and it's a little bit, I feel like it's a little bit safer. So running here, and then I need to figure out how to get it all the way back to the sub. So fingers crossed, I'll figure that out tonight. Look at that. Where did the RCA and the remote wire go? Well, I'll tell you what. So it's super dark right now, but like under this dash, I just ran it up over the steering column, and I ran it down, picked these plastics up, and then there's like a, you know, old school way would just take a flathead screwdriver, and there's like a piece right here, like a clip here, and a clip there, and you just pop it up. But I also have like plastic removing tools that you can get from Harbor Freight, and I popped those up, take this C-pillar, and I took that plastic up, and then over here, where the light is, did the same thing for this piece, and then took the seat down, folded it down, pulled this piece of the seat up. It has two like little pins that it rides on. Pop this up, and then take the seat down, and then I just kind of like wavered it through, and now have my RCA and my remote wire back here. So now I just need to figure out how to get my power wire from the front of the car, from the fuse box, back to the sub, and then I should have a sub. So for like the last 30 minutes, I've been trying to figure out how I can run my power wire, which is coming from my fuse box, either through the firewall this side and go down that side of the car, which is the passenger side, to the sub and amp, or going the other side. And I was gonna have to remove, this is like something with like the cruise control. I wanted to go and move this out of the way to go to an access port, which is like right on the other side of this, but I just was like, that's too much time, and I got only so much time. So I ran my power wire on the right side right here, and I just did a little tiny cut, and where like most of like the feed wires go in on that side of that firewall, spits right out on the other side. And I'm just gonna run the wire just like it would with the remote and the RCAs. It comes right out from like the firewall. I already got it running out, and I'm gonna just run it down this plastic all the way to the back. So now I just have an issue with like the ground, I'm guessing, because I don't have any power to this amp at all, and my head unit is playing music, but it's not sending the bass back here. So thinking that I need to at least get this powered up, and if it's powered up, then it's gonna be my remote wire or my speaker wire, so I need to figure that out, and then we'll see what's going on. So I'm driving this morning, and I figured out what my problem was. So I haven't had this particular setup in a car in about almost 2 years, and the night when I was working on putting this stereo in was about two nights ago, and I remember that I'm like, well, I remembered that the amp would only trigger the sub if it was like the song had enough bass in it. So then this morning I'm playing, you guys wouldn't know what it is, but Nightmares on Wax. And then I heard extra bass kick in. I'm like, no way. So then right now, you guys know like Lil Wayne, a Millie. So like if you guys are like at least 25 years old, you guys know that that song was the jam back in the day. And it had a lot of bass. So right now, I'm playing the bass boosted one, and this is I haven't done any tuning on the sub or anything, and I'm planning on getting another head unit because this head unit it's cheap. It has like almost no tuning capability to make it like the speakers go louder, like as loud as I want it to be. And so I'm gonna play a Millie real quick, and I'll show you guys that the sub is working, and then we'll go and be hooking up another head unit here soon. This is at 62 out of, or no, I'm sorry, this is 60 out of 62, so you can hear it, and the vocals are not that loud, but the bass is there. So I knew I had that thing wired up right. I can't wait to get another head unit. It's gonna be fun. Well guys, after about 3 days of just tuning on this thing, trying to get the head unit to compromise with like the sub and the amp and all its tuning capabilities, the head unit I got was $55. It's a Pioneer. It's great if you just want a replacement stereo, I'll give you that. But if you're trying to get your highs and your mids to be as loud as your sub, because that's a 650 watt sub, that's not the one for you. So I had to go and chimp in a little bit more and take it back, and then I got this JVC unit. So I'm a Pioneer / JVC kind of guy. I would never get Kenwood. I've only had problems out of Kenwood, but this one I actually went online and I looked at freaking JVC.com, this model, and it's got 13 different EQ settings, or Ben EQ settings, and then it's got a different couple like crossovers and high bass. Bass boosts, loudness. Everything that you want for like a stereo like of this caliber, which is like, you know, your standard amp and your standard just one sub, anything louder than that I've never even had. So this should work just fine, and I'm not even gonna show you how to wire it up and everything like that, because it's really simple. Like you could look that stuff online all day, all night. It's gonna wire up just like the other one. So I'm gonna wire this in and tune it up and see what it sounds like. Oh my gosh, this stereo 100 times better. It has so much tuning capabilities, it's unreal. So I got kind of into it for about 10 minutes, and I'm gonna show you two songs. One song that nobody's gonna know what it is, and then two is gonna be Lil Wayne, a Millie, a bit bass boosted, and we'll just see how loud that is. But right now I have my sub, if it was 0 to 10, it's about a 3, and then I got it set for like a amp gain and all that stuff too, and have it all really low, and then sub it kind of turned up on the head unit so it's not draining so much off my battery and my alternator. And so right now I'm showing you this song because this song has a lot of fluctuation in the bass, so it's high bass and low bass, so it's a lot of low end and high end bass. So I know you guys aren't going to know this song, but you'll appreciate how much effort I went into in tuning it. So the speakers right here are all just mids and highs, no bass at all. So all the bass you hear is just from the sub back there. Put it right in the middle. This song's really technical. It's a lot of bass. A lot of different bass. Nothing you guys kind of get the idea, is like what I wanted was where on a 12 inch or a 15 inch, it's harder for it to be able to capture every single pulse of a bass, like a bass sound. Like with the 10, it can reach it really fast for some reason. It's kind of hard to explain. My brother, he's a music guy. But now I'll go to Emily, because you guys definitely want to hear that. That was insane on my last stereo, so it's going to be really insane on this stereo. And this is volume 32 out of 35, so it's almost maxed. So hopefully it's not going to just blow. Oh, not bad. Okay, exactly how I want it. So a little bit of rattle. So my GoPro died when I was at the shop, and you guys kind of get the gist. It, like, probably one of the best stereos I've ever done, especially when I wire tucked everything under the carpet, and then I got all my wires all zip tied and electrical taped back behind like the amp and the sub and everything. It was like freaking money. And so I got about maybe $150 into the whole stereo, but that is not including the sub and the amp. All I did was buy a new stereo, and that was like $90 plus tax. And then I bought a wiring kit from going to the factory harness to the stereo, which was like $10. And I bought a wiring kit I basically only needed like a power wire, but getting a power wire was more expensive than getting a wiring kit. So that was about $26, $27. So that's like what, $90, $100, $110, about $140, $150. But then if you think about it, if you go on the Facebook Marketplace or Craigslist, definitely Facebook Marketplace, because Craigslist is junk now. So you can get an amp and a sub, $150, $200, no problem. And it makes a world of a difference. Like, if you're into that life, like I've was not into it, but now that I've been introduced into it, every one of my vehicles has got to have a sub and an amp, and just for like a home theater sound, not to like freaking just ghetto blast the neighborhood and everything like that, just to have a nice sound. And so that was the whole meaning of getting this done. So $150 later, I got a nice stereo in my car. And that's only the one thing out of many things I'm going to be doing to this car. So that and hatch, and it just depends on like the money distribution and all that stuff, you know. So I'm going to be editing this video at my house. So I'm going to be doing this video here and editing here soon. So thanks guys for watching and doing your thing, you know, liking and subscribing and commenting and all that stuff. I only got 90 subscribers now. And even if I hit 100, I'm going to be like, that's super blessed to me, because there's 90 people out there that like will watch this stuff. And like, I just like making the videos. Like, I only do it for the future, for me to be able to go back and be like, hey, I can't believe I forgot I did that and everything like that. So that's basically my mindset on like the whole channel, is just mostly for your guys' entertainment, but then my entertainment in the future. So I'll see you guys later. I'll see you on the next one.